But now, over to another crowd, over to another event. This is Litchfield for the Cobra speed trials. And there's enough rain here to make Jack Cousteau feel at home. There was an excellent turnout of the fast machinery for this short, tricky sprint. But it wasn't the best day for the cars with bags of horsepower. It was sometimes a little difficult to decide whether to keep yourself or your motor car dry, but by the end of practice, everything was about as wet as it could get, so it didn't matter. But vintage members are known for their cheerfulness in adversity, and Frank Wall's no exception. Dripping numbers were the order of the day, but they were still readable. And there's a steering system that's positively telegraphic. Freddie Giles, rain or no rain, he sets out for the start line. And it's difficult to get grip in this slippery weather. And on the line, rain doesn't stop the cars, it's just that you can't see to drive them. And somebody's told him, for heaven's sake, don't drop that flag. The circuit at Cobra is straight off the start, then a sweeping left-hander, followed by rather tight S's, and then down the main straight, which causes a patter of little Dunlops. And here's John Rowley and the Schneider. A very neat run through the S's, and then on to the sweeping right-hander, which leads in turn to the main straight. Here comes Lionel Stretton in the Fraser Nash. He's certainly being very tiptoe through the S's. And he's quite right too, because this was no place for the faint-hearted. And Nigel Arnold Foster was by no means being faint-hearted. By halfway through the afternoon, the track had become so greasy at the S's that even the most skillful were trying to remember the difference between understeer and oversteer. Ken Neave and the TT Humber, a very well judged and quick run. But for some, it was a question of getting it really crossed up. That's the Alvis of Humphrey Collis, trying to see if he's as wide as the track. And even the Fraser Nash Brigade were finding things a little twitchy. That's Guy Smith. And here's Ian Traynor. Only just holding their own on the way out from the S's. For some, it paid to pretend that the course wasn't there at all and just take your own route through the S's. And here's David Kurgan on his way to fastest time of the day. Frank Wall looks neat into the S's, but they eventually caught him out too. He was quite all right, all he wanted was a push. But the breakdown van set off at such a bat that he had to wave it away to save himself from being forcibly rescued. There were some who had their problems before they even got to the S's. And first prize for drama went to David White, who did the complete thing. The marshals run to the rescue, but it's the car which gets all the attention, not poor David. They have to push him out the way to get at the motor car. And here's a nice advertisement for Triplex coming up. And so, an unhappy 750 man returns the pieces to the paddock to end the Cobra sprint. And a frozen marshal is told to go home and thaw out. And when the times were added up, it was indeed David Kurgan who took fastest time of the day, with the fastest vintage time to Morton in the Bentley. This was certainly a day to remember, but mainly because of the weather.